A question we're often asked is, how long does it take to set the camper trailer up? Well, in this video, because it's a Google upload, I have a limit of 10 minutes, so we'll see how far we get. Anyway, I find the setting up process goes a lot smoother when you've got a refreshment at hand. Aussie Swag fridge is accessible at all times. You don't have to open the camper to get access to that fridge. Right, so here we go. On this side, undo the four latches as I go to the back to get the annex matting off the roof rack. I tend to use the annex matting on almost always, even on overnight stops, because it's just a nice surface to walk around on. It's very comfortable. Little William there can play on it without getting too dirty. So I find it's worth the effort just to put it out. That's why I always leave it on that rack there so it's accessible. But horses for courses, people do different things. So once that's out, spread out, the next thing I do is get into the tailgate, get the poles, marine carpet and bag for pegs and ropes out. Well, that's a fishing rod that I had stored between the marine carpet. Get the marine carpet out first, just in, especially if I've got dirty shoes. When I open up the trailer, put the marine carpet in first. Just keeps that floor a bit cleaner. It's only really an issue when you're in dirty, muddy conditions. Anyway, four poles for this side, plus the two on the front, and I get two out for the other side because I put up the shower room on this trip on the other side. Shower room I couldn't get done in 10 minutes. So anyway, the other four latches on the other side I undo. Also, because the land is sloping upwards, take out the rear feet. That way the floor will sit a bit more level. Refreshment break. And then over she goes. For a really quick overnight stop, really. A lot of people just do that. Put out the front flap, maybe. I always leave the awning on. You can see the awning's flipped over the roof there. So marine carpet goes in. And it's at this stage that I've just realised, as I'm getting the ropes out, that I forgot to bring my mallet. Just remembered, it's with the display trailer.
I got this one.
Thank you.
I was very quick.
Yeah, you were. Just put it there near that rock.
Right, so pull the awning over. zip it up to the end. Then you've got the four poles to do, plus the two front poles. So it's just a matter of how quickly you can do that. It's helpful to measure that large pole up against the camper to get the first one at the right height. It just makes it easier to get the level for the other poles.
So
finally I'll get a bit of help here. So as far as quick overnight awnings go, I really consider our normal 7 foot wide awning to be a quick overnight awning. Awnings need to be pegged down in case the wind picks up during the night. The last thing you want to be doing is getting out of bed in the middle of the night to rope down an awning. So, four poles, four ropes and pegs, less than 10 minutes. Helper's doing a good job there. A few more years, I'll be able to stick to the refreshment part while he does the rest. Right, front pole is pretty quick, just clips into a C-clip there, which you can see on another video. The rope attaches to a cleat that's on the stone guard. In this particular instance, I don't set up the other side as yet, because as I said, I'm going to put the shower room up, so leaving it loose is easier to attach the shower room. I don't think I've really cheated. Probably another 10 seconds. So there we go. Tension the ropes. Get the right height for the poles. Done. 9.5 minutes. Easy peasy, as they say.